The Thermalright TLG12 and the TL-C14 fans, in this case 120mm and 140mm. I purchased these for a PC build, quite a few of them of each. At the time, they were very low cost and they claim fluid dynamic bearing, so it sounded good. Add PWM to the mix, looks really nice on paper. Let's go over the specs of these fans. The 120mm fan, which is the G12, 1500 RPM. Noise for the 120mm fan is 23.6 decibels. Up to 62.6 CFM, daisy chain, 4-pin PWM. Does have rubber pads on the corners to help with vibration. Comes with standard case screws. On the frame itself, I don't see any indicator for direction, but it's a standard type of fan, so you can figure that out. With the TL-C14, that's 140mm fan, 1500 RPM, 26.6 decibels for the sound, 74.3 CFM maximum for the airflow. 4-pin PWM, does not have a daisy chain like the 120mm fan has. This one comes with case screws and rubber connectors, so you can decide which ones you want to use. In my case, I had to use custom screws that came with my case to fit them where I needed them for the most part, but then I used standard screws. Some of the benefits of these fans, I like the look, I like the color. It's just a nice simple gray. No RGB, I don't need any of the extras. Simple PWM, it works. Connected to the motherboard, connected to some type of fan controller, you'll be good to go. It does claim to have fluid dynamic bearings, so you would assume that's going to be better than the standard sleeve bearings. Let's get to the negatives. It is fluid dynamic bearing, but I have noticed some issues with weird sounds coming from the fans. My first 120mm that I put into the case, pushing air out of the case, it just had a scrapey, weird noise that wouldn't go away. I haven't tried to verify that it still sounds like that, but I just swapped it with one of my extras, and that one was fine. So it seems like they might have some manufacturing variability to it. So you could potentially have the hassle of having to send it back. One of the 140mm fans has a slight scraping, ticking noise to it that happens pretty rarely now. I haven't noticed it for quite a few days. In my Fractal Focus G case, the front fans have to use special, really long screws, and there could be just enough that it's warping the fan itself, and maybe that's why it's making that intermittent, occasional scraping type ticking noise. Hard to say, but this is what it sounds like. I switched from PWM mode to DC control mode in my motherboard BIOS. It seems more likely to get weird noises from these fans in PWM mode compared to standard DC power mode. So I switched to DC power, set them to a minimum of around 5 volts. They seem pretty good in that configuration. So as long as you can control various settings of these fans, you'll probably be good. You'll be able to find some type of configuration that sounds good. I was a bit disappointed that the 140 and the 120mm fans look different. It's just aesthetics, but it would have been nice if they had a very similar look and finish to them. In the case of the 120mm fan, the blades have a more matte finish to them, and on the back of the hub, you can see some of the metal. In the 140mm fans, it has a full sticker on the back, and the shape of the blades is different. The sheen of the blades is different. So you got two kind of similar fans in the case, but not close enough to be aesthetically pleasing. Just personal preference, I do have a bunch of black fans in there as well. Would have been nice if I could have gotten everything the same color and texture. And the frames of the two different fans, that is also different. The 140mm fans have removable rubber on them where you can connect screws to it. They don't seem as robust. With the 120mm fans, the rubber is built into it. As far as I can tell, not removable. So again, differences in design. I would have preferred to have the same design between different sizes. Now it's possible maybe I could have found the same model of a different size. I don't know if those exist. Installing and configuring the fans was easy. There's no hassles. Obviously, I did have some issues with weird ticking noises and such, but I've gotten it to a point where all the fans I have in the case work fine and they sound nice. Long term, who knows, but so far so good. Being able to control these fans with the motherboard is a really nice benefit. I'm able to adjust things perfectly to how I want. I set a minimum floor of the DC voltage, set the maximum, give it ramps when I need to increase cooling. Works really nicely with these fans. So I'm not sure that PWM mode is necessary because I switched to DC mode, but that's going to depend on your motherboard, how you want it configured. It is nice having the option for PWM if you want to use that. Consider it might take some effort in your motherboard settings to get these fans working how you want and how you want them to sound. Somewhat related to these fans, but mostly in general, if you do want the quietest possible configuration for fans in a computer, definitely get fans that are rated probably low CFM, but also very, very low noise. You're going to have a floor of fans like this with voltage where they're going to start sounding odd. So if you do want the quietest fans possible, get fans that are specifically designed to be under 20 decibels. Overall, these fans are a bit quirky, but I've been able to make them function nicely in my computer. They sound fine, they work, they blow air. Yeah, that's kind of the point. And they are configurable. You have the PWM. In my case, I'm using the DC power mode. That's going to depend on your motherboard, most likely. They have the fluid bearings in them, which should mean that they're quieter than sleep bearing type fans. In this case, it was going to depend on the voltage used, but other than that, not bad. That was a look at the Thermalright TL-G12 and TL-C14, 120 millimeters, 140 millimeters. Skype Tech, I suppose. See ya.